Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel and you don't know who I am, I'm Sarah and I make beauty and makeup related videos every Sunday. So if you're into that kind of stuff, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button and join the family. Now, keeping my voice aspect out of this because my voice is very hoarse right now. It's still like in the process of coming back. For this video, I decided to test out the most famous home remedies for tan removal on Google. Now, usually I get a lot of questions about what do you do for your tan and how do you remove your tan and all of those related questions. But personally, I never respond to such questions because I don't do anything for my tan. Whenever I'm back from a holiday or it's like summer in Bombay or it's post my swimming and all, and when I get tanned, generally I just let it fade automatically, like let my natural color just come back on its own, because one, all of these things take up a lot of your time, and two, I never really see them working that effectively and creating more of a mess. Like, home remedies create so much of a mess, so I just stay clear of them and just let my normal skincare routine just do the stuff for me. But this time, post my Pondicherry vacation, if you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I just went to Pondicherry and came back and I have sunburnt so badly. Like, I've not even tanned, I've sunburnt. I have dry patches all over my skin. My lips have sunburnt, my hands have sunburnt, my thighs, my everything is like a different burn. It's like red, not even like tan, it's red. So I decided, since I have time post this holiday, my college is not starting immediately, I have this 1 week to myself, so let's test out all the most famous home remedies on the internet. So every day I'm going to do one of the home remedy for this entire week, and let's see if my tan actually fades or, you know, has a little, even a little bit of difference. So let's just go on to Google and type tan removal home remedies. The first link that comes is by the blog called Maps of India, 25 ways to remove suntan naturally. So on this Maps of India blog, the first remedy they have is lemon juice and honey. It says the bleaching properties of lemon juice help in removing suntan from the skin naturally, while honey keeps your skin soft and smooth. Take 1 tablespoon of lemon juice and add some honey to it, apply it to your skin and keep it for half an hour and wash off. So let's do this first. I'm going to use this concoction for day one of this 1 week. Just going to put my hair back because I don't want to mess it up. So for all my face masks, I use this Vega face pack brush. It's very convenient. And I'm just going to take a little bit of this. Oops. Okay, so I've applied this on my face, both my hands, everywhere on my neck, whatever areas most exposed to the tan. I'm going to let it sit on my skin for 30 minutes, just like it said in the blog. It's 3:15, going to be back at 3:45 and let you know what I feel about this pack. Okay, so I washed it off. So far, I do really like this one. The first one's a total hit from my end because, number one, it did not create a huge mess in and around my room and also on my clothes. Usually with like haldi, chandan, any fruit or vegetable which these home remedy masks have in them, it creates a huge mess in and around where you're working or where you're applying the mask. Second thing is also that it's left my skin instantly a lot brighter than what it was. And it's also left it very smooth and soft and supple. Also that it came off very easily. It did not make my skin very dry or took time to come off. It just came off with a little bit of water. Felt a little sticky when the honey was on my skin, but now I feel nothing. So far, so good. I do really, really like the first one. Let's get back with a new mask tomorrow. Okay, so for day two, there are like a couple of options. Since there are 25 options, there's turmeric and Bengal gram flour, which is besan, but I'm allergic to besan and I know that I get like rashes every time I apply besan to my skin. So I'm going to skip to the fourth one, which is the honey and papaya face mask, since I have both at home right now. So the amazing exfoliating and bleaching properties of papaya makes it a perfect choice to remove suntan. The honey in this pack soothes, moisturizes skin. So pack preparation, mash half a cup of papaya together with 1 tablespoon of honey and let the pack sit for half an hour on the tanned areas. So that's what I'm going to do. I've taken papaya and honey in this and mashed it with my hands because that's the best way. And since I already have it on my hands, I'm just gonna apply a little bit on my face. I have a very strong feeling that this is gonna be one hell of a messy mask. But let's see how it works because I could really use some moisturization. Skin is becoming really, really dry. I'm applying it on my lips as well since my lips are also tanned and they're very dark right now. So just like I suspected, it's a super messy mask. It's on my sleeves, it's on my pants, it's on my floor. It's just everywhere, but I'm going to let it sit for half an hour and see if it actually helps with the tan. Okay, so I took the mask off and it wasn't that tough to take it off. Like, as compared to the lemon and honey mask, this one was definitely tougher because the papaya chunks just sit on your skin and don't come off. What you could do is basically apply this and then go for a shower. I've already had my bath for the day, so I couldn't do that. It was intensely moisturizing. Like, again, my skin feels very soft because, again, papaya and honey both are super moisturizing. And it has added a little bit of a glow to my face. I can't really see any detan so much, so of course in one shot you can't see so much of a difference. Okay, so this was the mask of the day. I think it was okay. I would rate it like a 5 out of 10 because of how much mess it created. It even messed up my hair, so I had to put it in a bun. I will see you guys tomorrow with a new one. Okay guys, so it's day 3 and for today I'm doing the turmeric and milk face mask. So it says the healing turmeric and exfoliating properties of milk make this home remedy a best pick to remove skin tan. Add a pinch of turmeric to 2 tablespoons of milk. Slather the solution on the tanned areas until dry. Wash off with normal water. So it just says to keep it until dry, not for half an hour like the other two masks. I'm not going to lie, this is one of my favorite home remedy face masks. As a child, I used to do this all the time. The only disadvantage is that if you do too much haldi, it might tint your skin, but that's just temporary. These masks are so messy, it's the most annoying bit. I'm gonna take this on a cotton pad because I don't feel the brush is the most decent way. It's tinting all of my bed sheets and dripping everywhere. I have so much left, I'm gonna apply it to my legs. If you have excess length left, you can always keep it in the refrigerator. I'm just trying a new mask every day. So this is already sort of drying up, so I will see you guys once it's totally dried up on my hands and everything, and then we'll wash off and see how it performs. Okay, so I washed it off and I can very evidently see a very clear glow on my skin, which I really like. This mask is actually a 10 out of 10 for me for multiple reasons. One, it shows a very quick effect. It really heals your dry patches, really glows your skin, and also makes your skin look very moisturized and supple and takes care of the dry patches. One is that. Second is, of course, it's a little drippy and a little wet, so it can mess around the areas, and haldi can tint wherever it falls, so it's best to do it in the bathroom. So just do it over the wash basin and then take a shower like 5 to 10 minutes later, because this dries up very fast, so you don't have to really sit for half an hour with it. The only thing is, if you have like polish, it's going to heavily tint the polish. That's what's happened right now. And if you're going for a party or an event, immediately after you've applied this mask and you feel like your skin is looking a little yellow or it's like a little sticky from the milk, you can always just take a little bit of toner and swipe that across your face, skin, and takes away that stickiness or that tint on your skin. So I have a lot of experience with this particular mask since I've done it back in the day. That's all I have to say after the lemon and honey mask. I think this one is very feasible, very effective. So I really like it, and now I will see you tomorrow with a new one. Okay, so we are back with day 4, and today's day I'm choosing the green tea face mask. Now, this was one of the 25 recommendations that says green tea is famous for its antioxidants, which are extremely helpful while treating tanned skin and reducing skin blemishes. Just dip a green tea bag in a cup of hot water, let it cool down, dab a cotton ball in it and apply on the tanned areas. Let it sit for 10 minutes only and wash it off. So that's what I'm gonna do. I've let this green tea really brew and cool down also. I took less water because I wanted it to be more concentrated than my usual green tea. Now actually I never thought of this, but a lot of skincare products do have green tea in them nowadays, and I never really thought of using green tea for your tan, you know. So I have heard that green tea bags are great for the under eyes, but I've never really heard about them being good for tan skin. So if this works, this would be such a great remedy. I'm just squeezing all the goodness from the bag. And if this works, it would be such a great remedy because green tea is like always available in the house. It's super easy to use and it would not even be a messy job, and it's not even expensive, so it's totally a win-win situation. I'm quickly gonna take a cotton ball. I don't have cotton balls in my house, so I'm dipping this cotton pad. You can, I think, make it even more concentrated than this. I'm gonna let it sit for 10 minutes and then see if actually it makes any difference to my skin. Okay, so straight up, a super easy mask to wash, a super easy mask to apply. But skin-wise, I don't really see any difference instantly, of course, because I kept it only for 10 minutes. And like, my skin doesn't feel instantly very brighter or glowing. It does feel very clear texture-wise. Like, I feel like if I had a little bumpy texture going on, it sort of smoothened it out. So the antioxidant must have done that. But I think this is a remedy you need to do more often, maybe twice or thrice a week, or at least once a week, and then keep on going to see a difference. With this mask, you might not see any difference instantly. So because it doesn't give you any results instantly, I would grade it like a 7/10, because apart from that, it's very convenient, very quick, very easy, and very accessible. I will see you tomorrow with the mask number 5, I think. Okay, so we are back with day 5 of masking, and today I want to test out a very, very weird one in this 25 list remedies. Something I have never even heard before. It says Vicks VapoRub. The Vicks we apply when our nose is congested. Applying Vicks VapoRub on the tanned area is an ideal remedy to treat sunburns. Now I'm really desperate because my sunburns, today I applied makeup and they were really emphasized with the powders and everything. So I really want to test this out. It could also be interesting to know if it harms your skin. I'm actually scared. I thought I wouldn't test this out at all and not recommend it. But you know, this is my job, I do this, so I might as well test it and then let y'all know if it's safe for y'all or no. It keeps your skin moisturized and reduces inflammation of the skin, which I don't know how that's possible. Leave it for a few hours for better results. You can repeat it every night for quick results. They have made a lot of claims. I'm not leaving this on my skin for a few hours. I'm only going to leave it for 15 minutes tops. So this is a dippy I have over here. Taking very little, I'm not going to apply it on my hands because it'll become very sticky and difficult to wash off. Wish me luck. Oh my god, such strong menthol smell. I've genuinely never heard this before. Keep it clear of your eyes, my eyes are burning. Oops, my skin is also burning. This is why I didn't want to do this. Because I could imagine how much my nose burns when I put Vicks, then how much my sunburnt areas would burn because they are more sensitive. I really hope this doesn't mess my skin up. Oh my god, this really, really burns. My eyes are burning. Put a little bit in my neck also will treat my voice. Okay, so I've covered my entire face in Vicks. This is one statement I never thought I would say in my life. But my eyes are really burning. I'm gonna let it sit for 15 minutes max and then wash this off. Let's see if it has healed anything at all, because this is one hell of a painful mask. Okay, you guys, it's totally dark outside. The lighting is off. You might not be able to tell, but my skin does not glow extra today with the Vicks. It's just a little tacky because I washed my face 2 times and this Vicks is not leaving my skin. So, firstly, I do not recommend this mask at all. 0 recommendations and 0 points from my side. Number one, because it's a very painful mask. It burns your eyes, burns your skin. Imagine doing this every single day and keeping this on for hours. And I washed my face 2 times to get rid of it, but I still feel that tingling sensation. Number two, you know when you apply to your nose, like how your nose starts peeling off, like the skin on your nose starts peeling off after a few days of having cold? That's because of the strong ingredients in Vicks, and imagine that happening to your entire skin. So I cannot fathom that, and I did not want to do this mask for that reason. But I just wanted to check if it has any instant glowing effect, which is like a sudden thing, but that's not the case. You might have to keep doing this, and instead of doing this, you'd rather do a number of other masks which you can do at home, or just buy one from the market, you know. So I don't recommend this at all. Not safe according to me. So tomorrow we'll come back with a new mask. It's the 6th day, right? So 6th mask tomorrow. So we are back with mask number 6, and today's mask is tomato juice and yogurt, which in itself sounds very messy. So I'm gonna tie my hair in a bun first things first. Okay, so this is the tomato juice and yogurt mask. It says the citric acid present in tomato juice is a natural tan remover. It removes dark spots and pigmentation from the skin, while yogurt moisturizes and soothes the skin. Mix 1 tablespoon each of tomato juice and yogurt. Slather the pack on the tan skin. Keep it for 1/2 hour before washing off with cold water. Okay, so I just want to say that tomato is one product I really trust when it comes to anti-tanning, because tomato has some great anti-tan properties. So as a teenager, I used to always just slice a tomato in half and like squeeze it on my skin, because that's the convenient way to do it. I've never really done it with yogurt, so I'm interested to see how so much citric acid reacts with my skin. Well, let's go ahead and apply this mask. This is going to be messy. It's all over my clothes already. Okay, so it's 5:30. It says keep the mask for 1/2 hour, so I'm gonna keep it till 6 o'clock, and then let's wash this off and see how it performs. Okay, so definitely a messy mask, very difficult to remove. Like the tomato just slides off, but the yogurt is like a sticky base to your skin, and it does intensely moisturize. I didn't realize how moisturizing yogurt can get till today. So it's feeling really, really soft. I actually really like how my skin is looking right now. And I don't know if you can properly tell, because again the sun has set, but my skin is actually glowing. This mask I recommend only before bath, because there are parts where tomatoes stuck, where yogurt sticky. So you might want to take a shower, not just apply this, wash it off in your wash basin, and then go about with your day. I really like this actually. Only for the messiness I might cut 1 point, but apart from that it's a 9 on 10 for me. And tomorrow we'll be back with a new mask, which will be the final one for this series. Okay, so it's the final day and I'm back with another home remedy from that blog. And today's home remedy is wheat flour. So it says this home remedy is perfect if you want to fight suntan along with brightening your skin tone. Combine 2 tablespoons of wheat flour with some water to make a thick paste and let it sit for 15 minutes and then wash. So that's what I have done. I've mixed wheat flour with water and made a paste out of it. I've not made too much because I don't plan to put too much on my hands. So today is the final day and we are going to also review all the home remedies we did till now. But let's start with this one. I applied this, it set really hard already on my lips, so I'm not able to speak. I'll be back in 15 minutes. Okay, so there are a lot of pros and cons for this mask. This mask is not for everyone, I feel, because this is like a proper face pack, and wheat flour tends to make your skin very dry. Like it stuck my skin, I could not speak. It made it like very tight, which is a good thing for oily skin girls. Really clears out your pores and took away all the excess oils from my face, which I had accumulated since morning. But for dry skin girls, this would be a nightmare. Like my skin has really had become very, very dry and like sucked out of all its sebum. So the dry skin girls might not like this at all. Like the other masks in this series mostly had yogurt or honey or papaya or something which was moisturizing your skin. This one literally has nothing to moisturize your skin, so you should stay away from this. And it's not even messy because it's a thick paste. Even though it's a home remedy, it's not messy, and I assume everybody has atta at home, so this is like easily accessible also to everyone. Okay, so those are my thoughts about this particular mask. Now let's compare from day 1 to day 7 how my skin looks and feels. Now I don't really exactly remember how my skin looks. I will of course put a split screen and compare the two faces right now. But I genuinely feel like these 7 days of treating my skin with home remedies has actually worked. It's no gimmick, all of these do have some properties which helps brighten your skin, helps take away the tan, and definitely helps heal your sunburns, because like there were patches of redness and dryness which was sucked out of all its nutrition on my skin. Even my lips had sunburned patches, and applying the mask to my lips actually was very, very beneficial. Some masks in the series were total highlights for me, which I would definitely recommend and want to do again for myself. One is the lemon and honey mask, very easy to make, very easy to apply. The second one was the tomato and yogurt, a little messy but a good pre-bath mask because very moisturizing. Then the turmeric and milk, which is a favorite since childhood, really helps your skin glow. And today's mask was also one of my favorites. I wouldn't not recommend the green tea one because I did actually feel that it could make a difference over time. And since green tea is very easily available and not that expensive, you could go ahead and maybe drink half your green tea and apply a little bit to your skin every day. You know, that's not so tough to do. What I do not recommend at all is the Vicks Vapor Up. Please do not try at home. I just don't have a good feeling about that mask. Apart from that, yeah, I liked everything on that blog. There are more masks like strawberries and milk, and there's oatmeal and honey, there's pineapple and something, and I feel those are very expensive masks. Like, we barely get to eat stuff like oatmeal, pineapple and strawberries and milk, so applying it to our face isn't really ideal. Yeah, that's all I have to say, and my tan looks a lot brighter just in a matter of 7 days. So maybe if I do this more regularly, more religiously, my skin might show a difference. Apart from these, I was just doing my regular skincare routine at night, and sometimes not even doing that, just applying moisturizer and sleeping. I'm going to leave a link to my skincare routine in the description section, so you can go and have a look at that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to leave the link of the blog I referred to also in the description section, so you can go and check it out for your reference. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did actually like this video, then please don't forget to hit like. Comment below, let me know if any of these masks are your holy grail, and if you want me to do more experimental videos like this. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also click on the bell icon right next to it, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys, love y'all.